It is Tuesday, October 4th, 2011. I'm Alex Jones, your host. This is InfoWars Nightly News here at PrisonPlanet.tv and InfoWarsNews.com. The true cutting edge in the exploding alternative grassroots media that is supplanting the globalist Federal Reserve funded corporate whore media of CNN, MSNBC, and Fox News. Coming to you from Austin, Texas tonight, I'm Alex Jones, your host. We've got quite a transmission lined up for you. Nomi Prins, a Goldman Sachs insider who now 8 years ago predicted the derivatives implosion we're seeing, will be joining us for an in-depth video interview. Also, we've had Rob Jacobson on the ground in New York reporting to us on what exactly is really going on with Occupy Wall Street and who's behind it. And we're going to look at Hank Williams Jr. Hank Williams Jr., of course, has now been fired of being the entertainment for Monday Night Football for 20 years because he supposedly compared Obama to Hitler. But if you actually watch the 30 seconds of video, that's not really what he did at all. It's okay to bash one party or the other for the establishment, but they don't like it when you decry the entire system, and that's what Hank Williams Jr. did. We're going to be analyzing that coming up. The first thing I want to get to, though, is Rick Perry. Kurt Nemo has an article breaking down the video that we're about to play. Rick Perry calls for sending U.S. troops to fight Mexico's drug cartels inside Mexico. We're not talking about troops on the border that's constitutional. No, we're talking about troops going into Mexico. This has happened several times in our history. It normally results with Mexico losing part of its geography, and we certainly don't want Mexico to be the 51st state. Let's go ahead and go to that clip.
That we were able to stop the drug cartels in Colombia was with a coordinated effort. It may require our military in Mexico working in concert with them to kill these drug cartels and to keep them off of our border and to destroy their networks.
I don't have words to describe how dangerous that is. Homeland Security for a long time has been wanting to invade Mexico. Let me break down something here for you, and this ties into Fast and Furious we're going to cover here in a moment. Celia Castillo, who was the top DEA agent in Latin America for more than a decade, former Border Patrol agent, you name it, in his own right. He told me 6 years ago on air, and those interviews are on YouTube, they're on PrisonPlanet.tv. He was part of Kevin Booth's American Drug War documentary that aired on Showtime and was award-winning. In fact, I brought Sully to town to be part of that documentary as a consultant. He worked with Gary Webb, the Pulitzer Prize winner on CIA drug trafficking into the U.S. But even though Sully came off as credible, it was still hard to believe what he was telling me. And he said, well, the Los Zetas works for the U.S. government. They've been trained at Fort Benning, Georgia. Years later, that did come out. And he said, they've approached me, and the U.S. government and CIA have approached me to train them down by the King Ranch, down in South Texas, to wage a war in Mexico. And he said, Calderon's going to get elected next year, and there's going to be a huge war down there, just like in Colombia, over the drugs, not to stop the drugs. And he said, the ATF is shipping guns in. Now, there was no news about this, no court hearings, no nothing. Now, 2 years ago, Holder comes out and he gives a speech about Fast and Furious. That's why he's been caught in perjury. The guy's been public with it, saying we're tracking guns into Mexico. What they were actually doing was sending tens of thousands of guns, and one shipment alone, 2,000, to the Sinaloa drug cartel. And we've done two or three past broadcasts on this just last month, showing El Paso Times. In fact, that's probably even still on the computer from a few weeks ago if you want to show it. Or maybe later we can do a report on tomorrow night. The point is, the El Paso Times, Chicago Tribune, all reporting what's come out in federal court documents, the government's admitted it, that yes, for at least 5.5 years, the Sinaloa cartel, that's the biggest one on the Mexico-U.S. border, has been given full authorization to shift in unlimited cocaine by the tens of tons into the U.S., and the ATF ships them guns. Now, it's come out in more emails and more testimony in Congress that the White House knows, Holder knows, he lied and said he didn't know. But the Republicans, who are now, some of them calling for a special counsel to probe Holder on the Fast and Furious probe, that supposedly broke today on Fox News, they're not going to be able to dig too deep because this goes back to Bush. This is Iran-Contra part two. It's now come out that the U.S. government, ATF, FBI, DEA, other agencies, seven in total, are shipping guns into Chicago, into Indianapolis, the drug route up north from Mexico, into Tampa. They're not just shipping guns into Mexico to the cartels that launder their money through big U.S. banks. They're shipping them all over the United States. I mean, this is so criminal. And they're talking about some big political thing where they'll make Holder resign and, oh, they screwed up and all this to get some political points. You're not going to fix this until you take it back to square one, to Vietnam and the Defense Department, the CIA, bringing the drugs into this country that's been declassified and admitted. And it went on through the 80s. I'm going to probably have Ricky Ross on tomorrow, who ran the drugs for the CIA, what, $50 million a day or so in Southern California. He just got out of prison. We are deep into this, deep into covering it. And yes, risking our lives to connect these dots for you. But they're there publicly. So here's the LA Times. Email show top Justice Department officials knew of ATF gun program and lied. ATF Fast and Furious. New documents show Attorney General Eric Holder was briefed in July 2010. He gave a speech, several speeches. In fact, one in Texas in 2009, bragging about Fast and Furious and how they were tracking guns. That was their cover. This is nothing but arming Los Zetas and others trained at Fort Benning, Georgia. It doesn't get any more obvious than this. It's open and shut. The mega banks that run America, the same ones that are butchering our economy, are working with the Mexican government to knock out the other cartels. And Perry says that we should send U.S. troops down there. There's different cells of different cartels in every police department, in every state police department in Mexico, in the military. There's five different cartels represented, and they're all fighting each other. And these people are about as violent and vicious and ready to die as anybody in the world. Our military is going to get completely chewed up. It's not like they're lining up and fighting Santa Ana or something. You know, this is guerrilla warfare. Over $500 billion a year coming out of Mexico into the U.S. And Rick Perry says, go down there and kill the cartels. You want truck bombs here in America? You want kidnappings? You want mass shootings? You want newspaper reporters being killed and hung from bridges every day? Let this drug war continue. Decriminalize all of this garbage. Decriminalize all of it. And it'll end overnight. Okay? But no, his answer is more war. Now, I know I spent a lot of time on this. It's going to be a two-hour show tonight if I don't shut up. But this is unbelievable. This is unbelievable. It's come out in federal court documents that they let 18-wheelers of pure cocaine drive through from Sinaloa right through these Border Patrol checkpoints 80, 90, 100 miles into Texas. There's scores of them. In fact, Rob, you had that map. It was like 15 of them in South Texas. I went through one of them Sunday. I showed you the video last night. They got drug dogs out. And I'm like, the government deals the drugs, man. You're not searching my car. Number one, I don't use your products. Number two, it's a Fourth Amendment. They said, well, don't videotape. I'll videotape if I want to. It's my First Amendment. You got cameras crammed down my throat. All right, I'm going to settle down. I've only gotten into one news story now. Good Lord. Let's go ahead and get into Honduras. Paul Watson reported last week on what even the New York Times admitted, but they said, oh, it's all right, it's for the earth, that in Uganda and other areas, the UN-sponsored World Bank groups are coming in and just slaughtering people en masse, burning down villages, shooting everybody that have been on the land for thousands of years to plant trees for carbon offsetting, because hippies, when they buy a gallon of gas, like to pay a carbon offset, even though it's voluntary, and they want to make it mandatory. And now it's been confirmed in the New American Magazine and other major publications that in just one village alone, they killed 23 farmers. They burn everything down. And it's all a UN program with the World Bank taking their land. I mean, it's just absolute genocide. And I just can't take it anymore. I told the story of in the 80s, we used to go down twice a year to Mexico, to Cancun for a couple days. Then my parents would drive me around with my sister, and we would see the pyramids and stuff. It's really beautiful down there. And my dad saw the brochures in the hotel, get Mexican land. And my dad's like, wow, Mexico's never allowed foreigners to own land. It's a sovereignty issue because they'd had Germans and others coming in trying to take over the country 100 years ago, Europeans. And my dad went and talked to the concierge in the hotel. He did some research. I remember him in the, you know, in the rented car driving around going, oh, this is a UN biosphere thing. This is when I was in high school. They're taking these farmers' property, sometimes at gunpoint, and then selling it to companies and others. But because it's under UN control, you're allowed to buy it, but just have one house on it, even if it's 100 acres, for the earth. And it's all these rich yuppies buying it. And then later he learned about the machete rebellions down there when the Yucatan Mayans rebelled against it. That's why there's 30 million people instead of 10 million now in Mexico City. That's why we got illegals crawling all over us who work for nothing. Because the UN went in with the Mexican army and blew their heads off if they didn't leave their land. They're like, where's the deed to your property? Well, my family's been here for 10,000 years. I don't know. You know, my 100 generations are buried up there on that hill. They're like, we don't care. You're not growing your corn here anymore. Get off. Some, you know, rich yuppie wants your land. This is the type of crap that's going on. But because it's cloaked in liberalism, I mean, I swear, if you painted a tank rainbow and had troops with Rasta hair, they could eat babies. And people would say, well, it's liberal. I mean, Al Gore, all of this. I can't take it anymore. I can't take it anymore. And under the carbon tax initiatives, the UN even admits, 1 billion people would starve to death in a decade if they put these carbon taxes on the third world. I was down in Mexico a year and a half ago in Cozumel, and I went out to rent a little glass bottom boat, like $50, you know, for 2 hours, take my kids out and show them fish and stuff and snorkel. And I went and I came out and I said, where are all the fishing boats? It was cool to pull up and see them, all the little fishermen catching fish. He said, the guy who could speak English, my wife could speak Spanish, she talked to him more, but he said in English, oh, they banned the fishing. So my wife talked to him in Spanish. And he said, yeah, for a couple of years now, no fishing allowed on the island and none on the mainland. Only the big commercial groups have given the government money and they pay them taxes. So now we're not allowed to fish. We have to go try to find another job. And man, the people 10 years ago, I go to Cozumel, beautiful place, happy people. They look like they've had their soul sucked out. This is a fishing island. People fishing for hundreds of years. They're not allowed to catch fish, because the multinationals come trawling, scooping it all up, but they pay the Mexican government money. You know, the big fat cats, the El Jefes, that sit up on top of it, little chiefs. I mean, this is what America is going to be like with the animal ID, the premises ID, all of this. I mean, this is a lot of commentary tonight, and I haven't even scratched the surface. It's just incredible what globalism is. And it's time to realize that tyranny always comes in a new guise. It isn't going to look like Hitler this time or Stalin. It's going to look like that. And real people that are, you know, liberals or you know, into all this stuff, you need to understand that just because something has a rainbow painted on it doesn't mean it's good. I could paint cyanide pills with rainbows on them. Would you like to take them? I mean, really, you got to get past the packaging. Just because something says, you know, it's got gold in it, you open it up, it can be horse crap. And basically, they're slaughtering people all over the place, but saying it's for the earth. That's like the World Wildlife Fund, whenever Prince Bernhard, the founder of it, the former Nazi, got caught running hunting operations under the guise of the World Wildlife Fund, defending animals out there getting their ivory in Africa. The British intelligence got caught using environmental preserves in Africa to launch takeovers of their indigenous governments. This is how these people operate. Stop being naive. Start looking into things. All right, I'm done. I'm done on that.